Today, we are joined by Tomas, one of the two founders of Medseg, a tool that uses machine learning to do some incredible work with segmentation. But first, though, Tomas, tell us about your background and who you are.
Thanks, Jen. First of all, thanks for having me. So I work as a radiologist, and the last 4 years I've been really interested in using artificial intelligence for segmentation, which I really think is a low-hanging fruit to apply AI in radiology. So I've gone and tried to create a segmentation tool that uses AI with the help of TensorFlow JS.
Well, that's awesome. So what exactly did you create?
So basically, it's a web-based segmentation tool where you can drag data into the browser and you can use several AI models to segment the data. And segmentation for radiology means that you basically, well, I assume most viewers know what segmentation is, which is basically a kind of contouring or I guess most of you guys know what that is. But when you do that for radiological data, you do it on multiple slices. And what that allows you to do is to get a volumetric information about how large certain things are, for example, organs or tumors, cancers and stuff. So that's what I've been working on.
That sounds really interesting. So, I'd really love to see it in action. Do you have a demo that we could check out?
I would love to show you. So I will go ahead and try to do a live demo for you. So first of all, I go here into medseg.ai, which is the homepage, and I start Medseg. And here you can drag data into the browser to open your own data, or you can just open one of the demo files. For example, this one, which is an MRI, magnetic resonance imaging of the prostate, which is this organ right here. And so here are some key commands that can be used. A lot of is key command based. And here are the TensorFlow JS models. So when I click this one, this loads the MR prostate model into the browser. And now I can place a point. Basically, the model is trained in the way that it takes user input along with image data as input and produces this result. And this allows me to actually place more points if I want to make it more correct. And I can place negative points to kind of correct the segmentation. And so this can be done for all of the slices like this, for example. And this is a really nice thing with TensorFlow JS, I think, is that you can interact with the AI models. It doesn't have to do fully automatic predictions, but you can actually kind of guide the models to get the result that you want. Or you can still use the manual kind of segmentation, which would take, of course, too much time to do on many slices. So we can just rename this to prostate, just for clarity, and we can now look at the volumes. So I have segmented the prostate volume, which is 65 milliliters in this case, which is a fairly big prostate, but not pathologically big. But yeah, so this can be done for any number of, any structures in the human body that have CT, computer tomography, or MRI scans.
So you mentioned that one of the benefits of using TensorFlow JS in this case was that you could sort of tweak and guide the model. Were there any other reasons that you decided to choose, let's say, the web option?
Yeah, so one other main reason is that hospitals usually, probably worldwide almost, are very restrictive in terms of what kind of programs you can install. I mean, you can't just download any program that you want and install it and use it on patient data. There's a huge process that you have to go through for each new program. So if you want to try a new model that you have trained at home, it's a really big thing It's really difficult. I mean, there are a lot of steps involved before you can actually try it. But the cool thing is that all hospital PCs have Chrome. And so if you just place it in the web, I mean, then you can just access any model that you want. So that was kind of the main reason why I went for this web-based approach.
Right. Yeah, that makes sense. Then you're not worrying about moving sensitive data around.
Yeah, that also, but also just to make it very simple to kind of be able to apply new models that you train on the data that you are interested in using. So yeah, and also the interactive approach that I showed you really kind of depends on you having very close access to the models that actually do the predictions.
Wow. I mean, I'm super excited about this project. And I have to imagine along the way, there were definitely some challenges. So what came up for you and how did you resolve those challenges?
I mean, the biggest challenges were just learning to program and just implementing, basically. And the first challenge was, of course, to just you have this data. How do you show it on the screen? How do you scroll between the slices? How do you get the manual thing working first? How do you like do windowing and see it the way that you want to see it as a radiologist? And then it was about actually using the TensorFlow part. But actually, that part was surprisingly simple by just following some tutorials. I thought that would be much more difficult to use. So the way we use it now is that basically I train any model on Keras at home. I do a simple conversion, which is just a one-liner, and then I kind of load it in the same way that I load in all the other models. And it, so far it kind of works.
That's awesome. So if folks want to learn more about Medseg, what can they do?
I mean, I'm really happy if people find it interesting and just going to Medseg AI and just, it's just one click away to open the tool and you can try it out with the demos, or if you do research or have real patient data in DICOM or Nifty format, which are the most common formats, then you can just load it in and try it on your own data. And so we have helped several research groups who have like come to us, found this tool, and they have provided their own data to us so that we have trained models for them. And they have used the models to create more data that they would need for their research. So that's one of the things that we have kind of done with people who have just found us online, basically. So I mean, just reach out to us. I would be very happy to speak with anyone who's interested. And it's really a thing that I really am excited about myself, about using it both in my clinical work, but also in the further development and just getting it out there and get people to know more about this.
So at this point, I have to ask, what are your plans for the future? And is there anything our wider community who are watching can potentially help with?
I mean, so we're right now implementing this system to actually run on local servers within the hospital system so that we can have like a whole database and everything locally instead of like having to drag one and one patient. But basically my focus now is just having it locally in our hospital. So that's like the short-term goal. As for what the community could do is, I think, like a general question about the thing. The problem is that there are so many like research out there for segmentation in radiology, and people generally share their models, usually without any clear guide on how you would can just take the model and apply it and like use it on your own data. And sometimes they have some kind of a workable executable file for that. But I think that it would be really great if there was a community that kind of took these really great models and basically just collected them and transformed them to TensorFlow JS models, and maybe made it open source so that, you know, anyone could just go out and really try the research that is being published instead of it, you know, getting lost there. So that's what I really would want to see. And of course, if anyone watching this is so excited about this that they, you know, want to work with us or anything, I mean, it would be great to hear from any of you guys.
So when folks want to reach you, should they just go to the website? Is that the best way to do that?
Yeah, I think that's the simplest way.
Tomas, thank you so much for taking the time today. And I'm really excited to see what's coming next for Medseg.
I'm very happy to show you. Thank you.